Floyd, what in the world's going on?
Everybody's getting gussied up for the big movie.
Hey, it's Court Howell here with another edition of Mayberry Man Behind the Scenes. And this week we're talking about wardrobe, specifically wardrobe for our background extras. So let's get into it.
Unless you're watching a period piece or something with exotic costumes, what the actors are wearing may go largely unnoticed. But it's important to understand that in motion pictures, everything you see is by design. The styles, the colors, the combinations of colors, it's always on purpose. So if you're planning to be an extra in Mayberry Man, you'll want to pay close attention so you can begin planning what you're going to wear for filming. Mayberry Man director Stark Howell wants to infuse vintage Mayberry into our present day story. And one way he'll be doing that is with wardrobe selection, particularly with background talent, the extras. So if you're going to be an extra in the movie, here's what you need to know. For the most part, you should wear what you would normally wear if you were attending an Andy Griffith Show festival. However, we will not be able to put licensed images in our movie, so that means no Andy Griffith Show graphics. We simply can't show copyrighted or trademarked images or designs. Shirts with visible brand names are also off limits. If you're wearing one of these, we will have to put your back to the camera or place you far enough away so that the logo is not readable. So what should you wear? We do encourage bright colors. Solid colors are always a safe bet, but avoid solid white or solid black unless it's part of a layered look. Busy patterns are hit and miss. Sometimes they work, sometimes they don't. And for some scenes, we might be going for more of a Mayberry type look as seen in the original show. If you have clothes like this in your closet, then we would like to see them. Don't feel like you need to go out and buy anything, but if you want to have some fun at the thrift shop, these images will give you an idea of what to look for. And if you have these options, it could get you a more prominent placement in certain scenes. To be an extra, you will need 5 separate approved outfits. We call them wardrobe changes. An approved wardrobe change means that you have taken a picture of yourself wearing the outfit, you've sent it to us, we have approved it, and we've assigned a change number to it. When we shoot the movie, we will shoot the script out of order. So that means we could actually be shooting a scene that takes place on day 1 of the Mayberry Festival, then have everyone change their clothes and shoot a scene that takes place on day 3 of the festival. You will be asked to change into one of your outfits depending on what scenes you're in. So you always need to have all approved wardrobe changes with you. Now, if this sounds like a lot more work than you planned on, don't worry. If you can't provide your changes in advance, we can still use you in crowd scenes or in a less prominent placement. But being an extra is a job, and for those who want to be working extras and really participate in the process, this preparation is required. If you signed up to be an extra, you'll receive instructions on how to send us your photos. Remember, it's not a costume contest. We just want to be able to see what you're going to wear before you show up on set. That's it for this edition of Behind the Scenes. If you haven't backed the movie yet and being a background extra sounds like fun, it's not too late. Head over to supportmayberryman.com and you'll see how you can join us. Until next time, I'm Court Howell. Thanks for watching.